gracious me! What is going on, guys? TVM here. Welcome back to the Road to Glory. More gameplay in today's episode than I think we've had in the last 2 or 3 months. So if you're into gameplay, this could be up your street, although I will just reiterate, like I do in every episode, it's not the most attractive of gameplays. It is... I mean, my opponent's doing that, right? And he scores another goal in just a second. The first, I would say, 3/4 of the game is actually played on stream. So you may have been there, you may not have been. You can go check it out live if you really want to. And there's another goal from an El Tornado cross. But even live, not bothered by it at all. It's just one of those things that's in the game now. Just got to get used to it and crack on. I do exactly the same thing here. Flick the ball up, bang, goal through a header. And that's 3 goals in that game from headers. And I think there's another one on the way in just a second. So, Punk Chaos says, I used 4 foot swap players to get the rare mega pack and I got Team of the Season Laporte from it. If I did that, you know full well that I would end up getting not even a board. Just the way of things, unfortunately. I don't know how many tokens there are left to get. I don't know how many I have right now, and I don't know how many I'm going to get from this week either. I've not looked at the progress of it. I don't even know. I can't even remember what it is. You've got to score flashback players or something? I can't remember what it is. I don't know if, to be honest, I'm going to be able to get the James Rodriguez that I wanted. So I'll have to look at that. I know I've missed at least 2. One was by choice. The other I think I forgot about. But we'll have to wait and see what happens with regards to foot swap items. I'm not that bothered. I picked up João Cancelo. That was the one I really wanted. I think I've got 2 tokens, maybe 3 max right now. If all goes pear-shaped, then I'll probably pick up that 55k pack as well. And we'll probably do it for... I don't know what team of the season it will be. I was going to say for a particular team of the season, but I don't know which one it'll be. TVM reviewing a goalkeeper. His jumping and heading just isn't good enough. To be honest, though, right, when you play the way I play, and that most people I've come up against this weekend have been doing exactly the same thing as I've been doing. They've obviously been watching everyone on YouTube abuse this part of the game, even though they are, I don't manage to score. So everybody is trying to build their team. Well, not everybody, but most people are trying to build their teams around that sort of play style. So the things that you look at first these days, instead of looking at pace, you look at jumping and you look at heading. And it's mad because if you go back to FIFA 15, 16, 17 and even 18, you would never look at the jumping. Not once would I look at jumping and go, oh yeah, he's got good jumping, that's good, we can use him. I would never look at it. It wouldn't have even come into... If you go back and look at a review from FIFA 18, right, for anyone, striker, defender, whatever, I would never mention the jumping at all, ever. But, you know, it is what it is. So, Try Hernandez, he is one of the best strikers in the game. This was said on stream a lot as well, right? So Hernandez being the moments Hernandez. I'm not quite sure the price. I had a look at his card, and I can't say that I'm that, like, taken by it. It just doesn't look like a card that would really fit the way that I play. He's got, believe it or not, good jumping. But I don't know. I just looked at it and I thought, oh, I don't know. Not really up my street. Like, that Roberto Firmino is a card that we'll get hold of. We'll go into the team. Kluivert has done so bad this weekend that I think going into next weekend, even if our rewards are absolutely dreadful, I may just go and spend money to get rid of him. Not get rid of him as in, like, you know, discard him or what, sell him or whatever, because I can't, right? But I may very well just keep him on the bench, or I've actually been very tempted to just throw him into an icon. So, for instance, Socrates, really want to start chipping away at that. We did the world-class class section. In fact, I might do the world-class section in this video. Can't remember. If I haven't showed you, it's in this video. If I haven't, if I have done it, then you've already seen it. I've done that, and I could start chipping away at the at that SBC once we've done Firmino, for high-rated players at least. But I'm very tempted to just throw Kluivert into the Socrates, pick up the 100k pack, open it while the Premier League Team of the Season are still in packs, and hopefully pick ourselves up one of the Liverpool Blues. But I don't know whether it's a good idea or not. What do you guys reckon? If we get Firmino, right, I can get Firmino into a team, or into this team, I think, hopefully, maybe, probably not, but we'll try. If I can get Firmino into this team to replace Kluivert as the striker going into next weekend, would you, I don't know, would you say, is it a good idea to just throw Kluivert away? I know we're not really, because it is going towards Socrates, but I just don't like him at all. I can't get on with him. Like, I've played 23 games weekend league. I didn't have enough time to play the final seven, which is really frustrating because, believe it or not, and it's going to sound crazy, I want to play the game. Like, right now I'm thinking, yeah, after this, I might go play a game. Just want to play more and more. I've been playing more games doing the reviews than I normally do just because I'm enjoying myself playing the game. And it's not attractive to watch the way that I play, but I'm enjoying it. I want to get, that's a great effort off the bar, but the rebound is a bit cheesy and it goes in. But I just want to get back on the field and I want to start playing again. I'm actually really excited to go back into Weekend League. I think the way that I'm going to do things from now on as well is, bar maybe the odd one or two games that I don't have time to fit in, or I will be able to fit in the nights, I will stream every single game that I play. So Friday's stream will contain probably maybe, I don't know, five games or so. The rest will be League SBC method and packs for team of the season. But on Saturday, I'm going to put in a big chunk of games, maybe 10 games. And on Sunday, we'll put in 10 games as well. Team of the week predictions for me now is done. I'm not doing it anymore until the Premier League kicks back up again, or the big leagues kick back up again, because there's no point. No one cares. No one watches it unless they change something about it, or they start introducing a different criteria or something. Then maybe we'll start kicking back into that. But for now, Team of the Week predictions is done. So Sundays, I'll have a little bit more time than I normally do to stream into the evenings. Now this Sunday I won't, because I've got to be somewhere. But normally what will happen is, I think I'll do 10 games Saturday, 10 games Sunday, and I might play 5 games Friday, and then in the nights I'll play the odd game here or there. So I probably will end up playing 30 games, 25 of which at least will be on stream. So if you want to watch them, twitch.tv/TVMBeta, B-E-T-A. It will be TVM Reviews once that Twitch allow me to change it, but for right now they won't or can't. So we'll see what happens with that. But I'll be playing all my games live, so I'll be able to get all 30 in. But like I said, I actually really enjoy myself with the gameplay. And Clivert has done nothing for me in the 23 games of Weekend League that I've played. He's played a bit of Rivals as well, so probably I would say about 30 games in total that he's played for me. And at the moment, at least, I just don't care for him. He scored, I think, maybe 4 or 5 goals in 23 games or 30 games. 23 Weekend League, he scored about 5 goals. He got about 4 or 5 assists. You might think that that's good, and to a degree, I suppose it's not terrible. You know, like over 10 or thereabouts, 10 goal contributions in about 20 games. I don't think that's good enough, personally, for a 92 rated, I think he's 92, icon. I don't really use strikers like normal people do, like, you know, to score goals. I rely on Bale and Ronaldo. Clivert is more there to pick up the pieces, and he's there to pick up the scraps, you know, the balls that sort of fly off the post, the keeper makes saves, etc., and then Clivert will be there to put it in. He's there for things like this. This is actually Ibra, though, instead of him, because I took him off at this point, but he fed Ronaldo. Ronaldo lifts it, and then, of course, it's in the back of the net, but Ibra's the one that scores that. But normally that would have been Clivert. However, I have zero faith that Clivert would have actually been able to put that in the back of the net. Now, let's go through this a little bit. I don't really like talking about this because people get triggered when I talk about it, right? So Stephen says, I want to know what the setting is for the cross. I swear I can't do a cross to save my life. What are you guys pressing for the cross? So when you actually put the ball into the box, if you don't flick it up and you just want to put a normal cross in, this was something I looked at on stream as well, actually. The ball, I was looking to see if it took a deflection, but someone in the comments or in the chat said the ball goes through Mbabu's arm. I wasn't looking at that. I was actually looking to see whether it actually hit him, because I thought, oh, that took a deflection. It did take a deflection, but it goes through his arm and into the goal. So physics 101 there from EA. That team is a little bit behind where it should be at this stage. So I was a little bit nervous going into it, because I was at a relatively high elo at this point, because I'd managed to win. I was plus whatever I was, 7 or 8. So I was playing against people who were around the same thing. And I thought to myself, if this guy is plus whatever with this team, then he must be good. And, the game unfolds as it unfolds, and you'll see what the result is. But the way that I would put a cross into the box, if you don't flick it up and you just put a standard cross in, you want to hold down the left bumper. So I don't score just crosses. One times from the edge of the area with Gareth Bale. The guy is insane. So you hold down the left bumper, whether that be LB or L1, whichever console you're on, and put about 3/4 power for the cross, but hold down LB because it's a driven cross, right? Same thing goes for the El Tornados and the flick-ups. you flick them up and then you just hold down LB and then smash it into the box. And again, you do an arrow ball and it just goes straight into the danger zone. And then when you do the header, it's not just a standard header. You can time it if you want, but you hold down both bumpers and you do the header. That is a downward header. This guy that I played, unbelievable. Not the player himself, but the team was absolutely incredible. The guy was decent, to be fair, and Babu scoring an own goal, not for the first time, believe it or not. But we do manage to nick one back. And I tell you what, I wasn't playing that badly. The guy was good, and you could tell he was good, but I really felt like his team was the edge. You know, like his team were just that good that I couldn't really compete with it. A couple of mistakes from me here or there. He definitely deserved to win. I'm not saying he didn't deserve to win, or I'm not bitter about it or anything. And I'm not like, oh, he's got a better team than me and I'm going to be sad about it. He went on to score, I think he went on to score another one beyond that. But it was a little bit undeserving that he scored that many goals. But his team put him over the line there. I think he was on the same level as I was, definitely. But no, well done to him. I did all right this weekend, though, when it comes to wins and losses. And I got a lot more in the way of rage quits than I normally do. And I think that's down to a few things. This meta right here is annoying as hell. If you concede goals and you lose a game to that kind of thing, like a 91st minute goal, you were drawing 1-1, going into extra time, or you were 2-0 up and you concede two or three back post headers, you're going to get miffed, right? So someone was in my chat and he said, I came up against this guy. And he was like, oh my God, I've just played that guy. I beat him in the 91st minute. I scored the fourth goal. It was 4-3 and I didn't deserve to beat him. So I instantly knew this guy is going to be on tilt. So I put two crosses into the box. It was one of the rage quits earlier. Two crosses into the box, bang, two goals, rage quit. Because he was on tilt and he was miffed by it. So I think that's what's happening. People who don't use this are getting really annoyed by it. And I more than understand. But it's one of the reasons why I'm enjoying the game. So, you know, is what it is. I don't know why. I like it. You know, someone, Stephen, who wanted to know how to do it. You know, not everyone knows how to do it. It's not something you can just go straight in and just whack a ball into the box, job done, goal. You do have to practice at it, but once you get it down, it is so effective. And like I said, I'm enjoying myself regardless of... when people do it against me as well, it's not even a salty thing. It's like this guy tries to get... I think he goes to the byline, gets a cross in, and then near post. He gets lucky, ball falls back to him, but still, it's a cross at the end of the day. But I'm not mad about it. I don't get salty. I think I raged maybe once. Good effort from Bale. I think I raged once on stream, and it was in a game that I lost 3-1. Oh, but the game was awful, man. The passes just weren't good. The guy, again, deserved to beat me, but passes just weren't working, and it was so frustrating. I want Ryan Fraser, but I'm not spending that much on him, and that is the problem with some of these SBCs. It's the same for Townsend, in my opinion. It's just a little bit too expensive for what the card is. Like, Fraser's very small, regardless of whether you care about playing to the meta or not. It doesn't matter. He won't be fun to use because he'll just get pushed off the ball because he's so small and he doesn't have the strength. Townsend will be a little bit more fun because he's got slightly more height on Fraser, of course, and a bit more of a sort of a presence. But again, he does lack a few things. I think composure may be one of the things that he lacks. That's a great goal. Not ahead of that time, but really good finish from Best on his weak foot. Why did I forget about the Ronaldinho SBC? I haven't forgotten about the Ronaldinho SBC. Ronaldinho would fit my team, and he would be an amazing player to get. The problem I have with Ronaldinho is that he's so expensive, and we've started Socrates, right? So I know that I've not done anything about Socrates for a long time, but now's the time to start really chipping away at that through Team of the Season. Hopefully, we'll get some upgrade packs soon, and we can start grinding those, and We'll get to do the upgrades much, much quicker. What a challenge that is, by the way, on the line from Gerrard to stop that gun in the back of the net. Essentially, I think, won me the game, because if that had gone in, we'd be 5-4 down and it would be GG. But down here we have Ibra, and I managed to find some space, pop the ball into the box. Great cross. Dabor on as a sub for Bale, and it's such a good finish. But I won't lie to you. I tried to cross it earlier with Ibra, and he refused to listen. And in the end, I managed to get through a couple of them and then put the ball in. And Dabor, I tried to shoot twice, didn't listen to me. And on the third attempt, he slotted it between the keeper's legs. So I feel like there's a little bit of dodgy play by EA going on there. This was an interesting game as well. I targeted Baresi. The guy is, what, 5'9"? You know full well, it doesn't matter what his jumping is. You put that ball into the box, it's going in. Unfortunately or fortunately, whichever way you look at it, Kluivert gets the winning goal because the guy's obviously just had enough. But I was just going to dump balls into the box for days there because I knew Baresi didn't have the height to compete. That Rare Mix Players Pack isn't from Socrates, that's from something else. But we got a walkout in it, and then when the blue ring come around, oh my god, I was so excited. I was just praying for any flag other than that flag. Unfortunately, we picked up the Saudi Arabia right back, which, you know, 85 rated card, not bad, tradable as well. It's from a league SBC. I can't remember what team it was, but not too bad. But when you get a walkout symbol and a blue ring, you honestly think, wow, this could be it. It could be the Van Dijk, it could be the Trent. Nope, it was some Saudi guy. That is the Remix Plays Pack for completing World Class on Socrates. Rising Talent, I will do like as and when. Don't know whether to put Clivert into that one. A guy, you can let me know in the comments whether you think it's a good idea to just throw Clivert into it. Obviously, we're going to be completing Firmino very soon. So it's not like I'll be without a player. Managed to pack Alan from it, though, which isn't too bad. He sells for about 7k, but I think I'm going to keep him because I do need 84s and such for whatever EA decide to drop at any point. I believe there were some SBCs dropped today, but they weren't good ones, although I do have a complaint to make about that, and my complaint is that I play on PC, right? So the SBCs were on PlayStation. It was a PlayStation kit or two kits. Two segments, one for the home, one for the away. I don't know if you've got anything for completing the whole thing, but again, same on Xbox, two Xbox kits. I've not seen the PlayStation kits, but apparently they are reissued kits, so you may already have them in your club. Bateson said that he already has the Xbox kit. So I was thinking, ooh, a nice Origin kit, you know, because that's the client that runs FIFA on PC. So I go into my lovely little SBC store, and I have a look, and I go, right, okay, we've got a few things here, of course. These are all expiring in a couple of days. There's the Fraser, of course. There's the Firmino that I've only got 3 days left to complete, but we're waiting for rewards. We've got Townsend there, Van Persie, Havertz loan. Oh, here we go. No, nothing. They gave the PC community absolute sod all, and I've never been so outraged in all my life. I probably wouldn't have done it unless the kit was really nice, and maybe I would have done it. But how? But I know a lot of you are like, yeah, but no one plays on PC. They do. They really do. If you go on my Twitch, I get so many people are going, oh, I'm on PC. Oh, can I add you? Oh, I'm on PC. So many people play this game on PC. And obviously, it's not like difficult to find a game. I go straight into games, no problem whatsoever. So there are a lot of people around, you know. I've very rarely come up against the same person twice. And I have, like, what, 1,100, 1,200 games. It's not difficult to find games. People play this game. So why do they not give us an Origin kit? Like, I laughed when I first saw Xbox and PlayStation people put on Twitter, oh my god, they've actually given us a kit through Team of the Season. And I was looking at it thinking, oh god, that's so pathetic. But at least not many people play PC compared to console. So I know I've just been banging on about how people do play PC and then said not many. I know it's a contradiction, but you know what I mean. Compared to console, yeah, there's not that many. But in videos, people are like, oh, what kit has he got? Because you can't get it on console, obviously. So I thought, I'm going to do that because it's you know, something to get comments in and you can. It might look a bit might look a bit cool. The Origin Access kit from a couple of years ago looked really nice, and I used that for a long time. But no, absolutely nothing. So I went from laughing at how pathetic it was to thinking, yeah, I'll do it anyway. And then to, oh, we don't even have it. Now I'm annoyed. Over a kit, I'm annoyed. It's crazy. But why couldn't they have just given us an Origin kit? It makes absolutely no sense whatsoever. We had one a couple of seasons ago for Origin Access, and now they just like, nah, you're all right. So that's pretty much going to be the end of the video because there's not an awful lot more I can do here. When it comes to packs, what day is it tomorrow? Tomorrow I will have some packs for you, I think. And of course, I'm hoping Tuesday will give us the guaranteed Premier League team of the season. I think everyone is hoping for that. But knowing EA, they will probably just drop a ball. You know, it's literally drop the ball. But no, I don't know. No one can second guess what EA do these days. I'm not too far away from the Premier League, so these will be the packs that I get. I'm going to have to complete this. I'm going to have to get loyalty. Otherwise, I would do it right now. I have to get loyalty on one of the players. The centre mid. No, not the centre mid. The left back, who is actually a left mid. Have to get chemistry on him, and I don't have time to do it now. Otherwise, the video wouldn't be up till God knows when. So that's going to cost me about 20-25k to complete. Not too bad. And then I've got Manchester City to complete, which is going to cost me a fair bit because Bernardo Silva isn't in packs, but he's still the cheapest way to do it. I've worked through it. I don't need loyalty for that, although I'm pretty sure there is a cheaper way to do it. I think he's quite expensive. Yeah, I'm not buying that. There is a cheaper way to do it. I'll have to work it out. I can't quite remember what it is. putting Mendy to left wing back and then maybe putting a goalkeeper here, I think, is part of it. I can't remember what it is exactly, but I may need loyalty on that as well. But it's fine because I have to go into loyalty for, yeah, Grimshaw, I think I normally have. So that gives me 89 chem. There will be, what are we saying, 1, 2, 3 more chem to come there. So that takes us up to 92, and then we get 3 chem from converting him to a left wing back, or to a left wing back, which is 95, which will be the chemistry we need. So that is what I need right there. Job done. Just need to buy it all. Most of which aren't expensive, but Bernardo Silva is going to cost me about 10k. Gundogan at the moment, I think, is around, yeah, we're looking at about 7 or 8k for him. So all in all, that's going to cost me a fair bit. But once it's complete, we get a 35k pack, we get the Cardiff pack, and I can complete 10 teams instantly without buying anyone else. And that, my friends, is the League SBC method. So it's probably going to cost me the best part of, say, 40k to do both of those, Man City and Cardiff, maybe even 50k, but we'll hopefully make that back in the packs, and we will get some decent packs back for it as well. But for today, unfortunately, that's it. Where did I finish weekend league is what you want to know, though. I finished, my friends, in a pretty decent position. Time was the more annoying thing, but like I said, because I'm not going to play them on stream, I will be able to get nearly all the games done every week. Sometimes we'll do well, sometimes we'll do bad, and, you know, depends on my mood when we go into games on stream, but it is what it is. For this week, though, we did finish gold 2, and like I said, I did only play 23 games. I could have gone for gold 1, and I could have got it quite comfortably, I would have thought. The way that I was playing, how good I felt, I could have picked up 2 100k packs instead, though. 2 55k packs and 1 25k pack. We've got 2 picks. We guarantee ourselves a Premier League pick, and we get 4 choices instead of 3, I believe. We've only finished gold 2 once this year. Rest of it was gold 3 and a couple of silver 1s. Next week, though, I'm pretty confident we can hit gold 1. It wouldn't have been that difficult to get 3 wins from 7 games for the way I was playing. The question is, could I have got 6 from 7? Because that would have pushed us into elite. I think that may have been a step too far. The annoying thing is, I did take maybe 1, maybe 2 defeats that were a little bit, you know, could have gone either way. So if I can eradicate that and maybe get to 17 wins with maybe 8 or 9 games left, then Elite 3 is 100% a possibility. I'm not ruling that out. Gold 1 is standard, though, I reckon. That would have been straightforward enough if I'd had time to play the games. Unfortunately, I didn't. Next week, though, is another week. Shame we're not going to get those 100k packs, but it is what it is. Let me know in the comments whether you think submitting Clivert is a good idea to get that 100k pack back from Socrates. Anything high rated will go towards Firmino. We'll get Firmino on Thursday regardless of what happens, and he will replace Clivert, so it's not like I'm going to miss him. But does it make sense to do it now, or should we just wait? What do you guys reckon? My logic is that it's a Premier League team of the season, so it does kind of make sense. But if you have enjoyed today's episode, do me a favor and smack the like button. Let me know where you finished in Weekend League. If you played it, of course, subscribe to the channel if you're new. And until the next time, goodbye.